So let's get cracking with this installment of Soccer Chat Match Pack, shall we? So let's start off with Zedi Sailete's debt with Tenan Chilumba. Well, both coaches have got strong history in Kitwe. But let's have a look at the starting lineups that both made without further ado for this battle, which was staged at the Heroes National Stadium. So for Tenan Chilumba, in this game, basically played a 4-4-2. And sometimes the variation he used to vary to a 4-3-3 formation, where you'd have two attacking midfielders. And for Nkana and Zedi Sailete, that was the formation, 4-1-3-2. Jacob Ngulube playing in the hole. Now, this was a big game, Freeman, for Nkana. If they didn't win that game, God knows what would have been said. The Black Mountain, at the Kawoma branch where people support Nkana. I'm just wondering what the conversations would have been at Sokone Market.
Exactly. You know, Nkana is a very big team, and in the Copper Belt, almost everybody is looking at them. So having won this game, I think it really brought that boost to them.
Okay. So now, Zedi Sailete played, I think, the formation we knew, but I was just asking myself, one role that will be played by Jacob Ngulube in the hole. I mean, he was a success at Maite, and I'm sure that's what Nkana want him for. Could he be the only number 8 that the league craves for?
Exactly, Zite. I'm sure you and me were together at the ground. We went through the games and stuff. After we spoke, I spoke to Coach Zedi and I called you. You came to the ground. Are you denying?
No, I'm not. Let's get cracking. Nkana had a problem with creating opportunities in the first half. Let's just get to understand the craft behind that graft, or not successful graft. So that was the thing. Jacob Ngulube playing in the hole. Now, that was the average situation where you had McDav Chungu playing as the right back, going up, giving Chamanga something to think about, playing as a left winger, and everyone was going forward. But again, you could see how well organized NAPSA Stars were in the central areas. Dixon Chapa there and Enoch Mwepu in the central area. So no real space for them to penetrate. But something I didn't understand, and perhaps someone needs to translate that. So we saw Jacob Ngulube, the number 17, when he gets on the ball, he makes that run to the right side of attack. And what makes it worse is that Shadrack Msonda is not occupying the space that is left. Donashano Malama is sticking close to the central defensive pairing, which is correct, and within his right. So I'm just thinking, Shadrack Msonda and Jacob Ngulube should have a rapport if we are going to allow him to make that diagonal run into that space, Dennis.
Yeah, I think, you know, these our players, you know, when we give them instructions, like the way what I saw Nkana and NAPSA, Nkana defenders were so conscious. They were not moving up to go and close those spaces, but they were always in defense. I don't know, it worked for them, yeah, because they won. Because they were doing counter-attacks. NAPSA makes a mistake, they make a counter-attack, they go and attack. But I thought if they had followed Coach Zedi's instructions, we don't have the ball, a midfielder, you close or you open up, I think.
Okay, it could have been better, but now, let me bring in Freeman now. Now, in that situation, you've got Sate Sate, who's waiting for service from the central areas. It's not coming because Jacob Ngulube is going to have a picnic on the right-hand side of the pitch. And guess what? Nobody's filling in that area. I'm sure it's mighty frustrating for a striker then now. You need to start coming short or there's no service. I'm sure it works on your psychology at that point in time.
Exactly. If you look at the way the defenders were positioning themselves, you could see that that is according to the tactic that they were given. They know what the strengths are for Sate Sate. If you leave him just for a few seconds, Sate Sate is very dangerous. And then also, if you can see the distance between the attacking midfielder and Sate Sate that was created by the by the defender that was in between them, the number six. You can see that he made sure that no through balls can get to him unless they are on top. And I think that is one of the things that could have made the game a bit more difficult for Ghana.
All right, so that was the situation. So found it very difficult, and they had to endure 45 minutes playing almost like that. And at halftime, perhaps it took an inspired decision and an inspired pep talk by Zedi Sailet and his charges, because finally, Ghana scored not once, but twice. But let's just show you why and how Ghana scored. It was a big game for them, a big game that they needed to get goals. And probably here's something that was working right. So now, Zedi Sailet going into the second half, changes formation from 4-1-3-2 to a 4-3-3 formation, attacking formation. Here's what happens essentially on the pitch. So you've got Jacob Ngulube double teaming with Fumbanimu, the shirt number 11 there for Nkana, who was actually giving them more thrust. 2v1 against Dickson Chapa. Then apparently for Napsa Stars, and perhaps they got very comfortable, they were doing this in the second half and they got away with it. Austin Banda, the number 10, top right of your screen. He's walking back. Mwepu is not in position. You do not have the ball. It's gone past him and everyone is moving majestically. Chitia Msusu should be getting behind the ball. Even Twiza Chavera should be getting behind the ball. Chamanga as well. These guys didn't do that. And because of that, Ghana got a goal from there because, again, look at where Boyd is. Boyd is closer to the action and his ball side and goal side of where the attack is coming from. But if he runs, he leaves McDuff Chungu free there to probably provide the cross. And it's 3v3 in the central areas. And it was curtained. So Ghana get the first goal from exactly that situation. And for the second goal, it's because now Napsa Stars are looking for a goal. They move the line up and they concede another one.
Yeah. I think on the first goal, Napsa Stars were concentrating more on the defensive part. They were caught on a counter. I think that's what happened even on the second goal. Ghana were defending, and it just so happened Napsa were hit on the neck.
No, I'm just thinking, Freeman, this steps aside, young squad, Tenant Chinumba has just flipped the script there. He's gotten rid of some of the old guards there. And he's starting to think, now, does this team have the maturity? Do they know when to press? Do they know when to hold back? Do they know when to do what, essentially?
Well, what I can say is, in football, it only takes a second for a very short time before you make a small mistake and you're gone. So I think for their start, they did very well. They did quite well. They were able to hold on to their defense, but immediately they made a small mistake after the coach made a few changes. You can see the positioning had seemingly changed and the way they tried to attack. They just created a very small position and they were able to score. So an issue of maturity in the players, yes, does matter a lot. But I think without that opportunity, we won't have a future for players. So
yeah, but perhaps it's, again, young players who believe they've got a full tank and it must finish today, Dennis.
Yes, I think for me, Zite, the way Tenant is doing it is believing in everyone. He believes in every player that he has. So I thought if he was thinking, if I put this one is going to deliver. But it's about the player now to believe in himself.
No, I'm asking you this. You've played as one of the youngest players in the team.
Yeah.
One of the players at the peak, and now you are becoming an old man.
Yeah.
And now you are seeing the youngsters busy burning fuel anyhow, just spraying everywhere, and they're not managing their runs. Perhaps, I don't know. That's the worst thing about being young.
Yeah, you see, we played Pau. I was watching Fuayo. I think Fuayo is one of the players. Fuayo and Given Singuruma. I haven't watched Given Singuruma for a long time now. they are the players that I've seen. Fuayo, Given, and Roger, they're the ones that are there, you know, between what I've done and what I'm still seeing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so I was watching Fuayo and what he was doing. He was complimenting the coach. The coach, the belief of the coach is ending here, and he adds more.
Yeah, that's what the experience gives you.
So, and that is what is not at NAPS.
Exactly.
Twiza is still a young boy. And if you put him as a
focal lead striker with Chitia Msusu, another young man.
I'm sorry.
Exactly. But you know, one thing is, if these young players are not given the opportunity, where are they going to get the experience from?
But exactly what I'm saying.
And then this is, the league is only beginning now. So I think this is probably the best time for them to get experience.
I don't really mind so much.
I think
Freeman, listen. Now, if we give you 90% of the time that you mature, when are we going to mature?
No,
you don't need to answer that question. Let's make progress. Tenant Chirumba made some changes to try to remedy the situation. Let's just have a look at the effect that the substitutions that he made. So he brought on Maunga Kawuku, he brought on, you remember, Banda, and he brought on Twiza Chaivela. Those are the average positions they took. Now, I was a little bit surprised. Maunga Kawuku takes the wide left row. I never thought that was ever going to happen. But anyway, it happened on Saturday. He took that row, and clearly it appeared to me his instructions were like, take them on. You go there and try to get as a goal. Firefighting. But one cardinal thing is that you remember Banda was deployed in the central areas. Now, similar situation. Remember you had Austin Muowo and Ngulube actually double teaming against Dickson Chap and creating all hell and menace for them. So Tenant Chirumba tries to do almost the same thing. But here's the problem. Because NAPSA Stars have been playing long, and Chitia Msusu still believes we are playing long, Mwepu still believes we are playing long, and Maunga Kabuku is just being a senior man in there, defensive midfielder. He's on the left. What does he do? Just stand in that pocket there. But no formation of lines of pass. Donashano Malama, he's looking at Donashano Malama right in the face, and he's saying, you're not going anywhere, Mr. You Remember Banda. You will remember that my name is Donashano Malama, and you're not going anywhere. So, basic option. Twiza on the right, Maunga on the left. But the routine is that these players want to play long. And with that attitude, and look, Katebe, Sinyangwe. It doesn't appear to me that those two lads are going to win duels against that central defensive pair.
This one, Zita, I can surely assure you. I was looking at this game. I didn't watch it live, but I saw it afterwards. You put the number 7?
Shadrick.
Very quick. NAPSA, very slow. They put the other...
Maunga Kabuka.
Yeah. Maunga. Oh, what he can do is... He's very good with experience, yes. What he can do is he can hold on to the ball, pass and stuff, but... What Shadrick brought in the Nkana thing was different to what...
Yeah, let's also deal with something, is that whilst NAPSA Stars had, a plan to probably take them on, use the youth and experience, Mkandawire hardly went forward. And part of the reason is that they were going long and long too fast. Because of that, you leave Boyd Mkandawira at the back where he's practically making up a flat back four. And you need numbers up front. And because of that, you can't really create overloads. And you think, those players who are on the bench, what are they thinking?
Yeah, you know,
in terms of the whole game, like, what is going to happen? We're not creating chances. And the senior players are saying, boy, these kids, pulling their hair out.
That's true. You know, for the thing of Mkandawe, I think one of his strengths is his cross. So he has quite a very good cross. I've actually played with him a number of times, and if he's not doing that, I mean, then why is he still there? And the only worry that he has is that when he goes up, he's a little bit slow when it comes to coming back, and his positioning isn't so good. So I think if he can continue trying to work towards crossing the ball, even just after the center line there, I think it would be a bit more possible going forward.
Yeah, but I'm also thinking, if you play Boyd Mkandawira with that situation we're seeing in midfield, he goes forward, Maunga Kabuku or Chaivela, whoever is playing there, goes up. So it creates a serious deficiency on the left side or on the right of the opponent's team. And then you say, could TC have told Boyd, when you reach the center, pack? Is it possible? Can we have that such a crazy thought?
I don't think so. Because
So it was just people playing along.
Yeah.
Going, wanting to go fast too quickly.
Exactly.
Thank you. Let's look at one final slide regards our match analysis for this game. Fragmentations of the lines by both teams. And again, look at this. On average, look at how both teams are spread all over the pitch, even when the ball is right in the middle of the park. And if you're talking about compactness, and again, this is where the maturity comes in. Mwepu is running on the edge of the area because, as far as he's concerned, the ball that he should receive to score should be a flighted ball. Chitia Mususu, well, they're both going there. Chitia Mususu is not even creating space for Enoch Mwepu. They're just banging themselves right on the edge of the D or the 18. It makes defending very easy. And I'm sure as a striker yourself, you would love to play in such a football match, especially if you're a Madara. The lines are not compact.
Yeah, of course.
I mean, you can be walking back and nobody's saying nothing.
Exactly. I mean, exactly. So
you can even take a walk.
Yeah.
It's like taking a stroll in a park.
Yeah. Well, that's the situation. Soccer Chat Match Pack. That's our first dose of analysis. That was Nkana versus Napsos.